Hello there. My name is David Ryglicki, and I'm currently a meteorologist at the Naval Research Lab Marine Meteorology Division here in beautiful Monterey, California. And today, I'm going to be talking to you about some rotating tank experiments. Now, what's sitting in front of me right now is said rotating tank. And we're going to be using this as a way to model the Earth's atmosphere. You know, we live in the Earth's atmosphere, and it's air, and we have water in the tank. Well, we can actually get the two to behave very, very similar to each other. Now, the Earth is very complicated because you have, you know, fronts, you have mountains, you have oceans, deserts, forests, etc., etc., and that gets very complicated. But we can actually simplify that in our tank here and model some of the basic processes of the atmosphere and help us figure out what's going on. So right now in our rotating tank, we have a hockey puck sitting down there, and the hockey puck is going to act as a mountain. So like I said, we're going to be focusing on flow around this mountain. So what I've got here is colored dye, and essentially what we're going to be focusing on is how the Coriolis effect changes flow around the mountain. Now the Coriolis effect is, the best way to think of it is like a phantom force. So right now, think about, we're looking down on the Earth from the North Pole, and the camera is moving with the Earth. So the camera would be like us standing on the Earth right now, but where we're standing looking at the tank back here, think of it, we're kind of in space right now. So right now we're going to see if we can simulate flow around the mountain in just this simple demonstration using just colored dye, a little hockey puck, and a rotating tank. So I'm going to wait so I don't get clocked by that. All right, and let's give it a try. So here we go. So we've got our little dye, and we're going to speed up the tank a little bit. Now what's going to happen is that the water is moving a little more slowly than the puck. So the puck is actually coming into, you can actually see this little rotating fluid here of the dye. So the puck is going to be getting closer and closer and closer and closer. And what we have is this cyclone, this dye, is approaching our mountain. So we're going to see what happens as this cyclone approaches our mountain. So basically what you want to see here, the analog of this on planet Earth, is that you actually have a cyclone or just a piece of air coming towards this mountain. And what we're concerned about is what happens when it hits that mountain. Does it go over? Does it go around? Because you get different behaviors of this depending on how it goes, how it moves, where it goes, all that kind of stuff. So as it moves around the mountain, sometimes you're going to get what's called lee side genesis, or maybe it's going to go all the way around. And actually, what we're seeing right here is if you look at the very top, you'll see that this flow is actually going around, it worked, is actually going around this hockey puck at all levels. So right now, we have basically tricked this fluid into thinking that this hockey puck is a lot deeper than it is. Now the technical term for what we're looking at here, if you want to impress your friends or something like that, this is called a Taylor column. And we're seeing a manifestation of what's called the Taylor-Proudman theorem. So basically what this says is that given the right setup, you can actually fake a mountain being a lot deeper than it actually is. So you see that none of the dye, or virtually none of the dye, is going over the puck. It's being all forced around it. And you can actually see something like this in the atmosphere, is that depending on which way the cyclone is spinning, it'll move in a certain direction. And yet, all of this stuff, you see these little eddies here and an eddy on the downward side, but it is all going around the puck. Doesn't matter what height, so we have actually successfully simulated a Taylor column. So, there you have it. We learned all about Taylor columns, flow around a mountain. Hope you learned something. Hope you had fun. See you later.